Good morning. Welcome to this annual Arbor Day observance by the City of Jacksonville, the Jacksonville Tree Board, and the Jacksonville Environmental and Appearance Advisory Committee. Jacksonville has a long tradition of observing Arbor Day and supporting beautification efforts. A long line of citizens have served to lead, advise, advocate, and do hands-on work to advance efforts that improves the appearance of our city. Today, those of you here and those of you who watch this ceremony and agree in spirit to our efforts become a part of the legacy of seeking a better Jacksonville through improving our appearance. Today's purpose is twofold: to celebrate Arbor Day and what it means, and to add 5 more trees to the urban forest of the city. Another purpose could be to gain even more into our efforts. Our committee hosts the Adopt-A programs, where you could help in community cleanup of streets, streams, parks, and trails. You may go online to the city website, call the city hall, or talk to one of our committee members about these programs. We stand today in a spot that was once a forest. City leaders had the wisdom to purchase the site, and we have made good use of it. Today, we return 5 trees to the site and celebrate what trees mean to us. Let us begin with the representation of our great nation. We are privileged to have the Northside High School ROTC to present the colors. We will then follow the pledge by the Jacksonville Commons Middle School Ladies of Quality, and then by an invocation by Reverend Jill Churchwell. Please present the colors.
Salute. Pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Retire the colors. You may be seated.
Let us pray. Oh God, we thank you for this earth, our home in the wide sky and the blessed sun, for the ocean and the streams, for the towering hills and the whispering wind, for the trees and all the green grass. We thank you for our senses by which we hear the songs of birds and see the splendor and are able to taste of the season's fruit, and rejoice and feel the rain and smell the breath of spring flowers. Grant us a heart open wide to all this beauty. Save us from being so blind that we pass unseen. Even the common weed is aflame with your glory. We thank you now in Christ's name. Amen.
At this time, I would like to welcome and bring special attention to some officials who are among us today: Dr. Richard Woodruff, Councilman Jerry Bittner, Councilman Robert Warden, and Mayor Sammy Phillips is also with us. For many years, the mayor has provided a formal acknowledgement of Arbor Day, and today he continues the tradition.
Thank you, Suzanne. It is an honor to be here today to perform the official duty of proclaiming today as Jacksonville's Arbor Day. I strongly believe in the value of the trees in our community and see the improvement that they've made, particularly now that we are fully engaged in our clean and green campaign here in Jacksonville. This time I would like to ask Suzanne if you would join me up front again for a moment. I have a proclamation that I would like to read. Whereas Arbor Day is celebrated to emphasize that we believe in the importance of tree planting as a legacy for future generations. And whereas trees protect land and structures by reducing runoff, binding soil, and minimizing flood damage. And whereas trees develop community pride and unity by giving people an opportunity to work together as they plant and care for them. And whereas trees reduce the cost of controlling stormwater runoff, in addition to offsetting greenhouse gases from cars and homes. And whereas the City of Jacksonville, through our landscaping and urban forestry efforts, will continue to beautify our city by planting, caring for, and preserving our trees for future generations. Now, therefore, I, Sammy Phillips, the mayor of the City of Jacksonville, do hereby proudly proclaim Arbor Day in the City of Jacksonville, and I urge that all citizens celebrate this special day by supporting efforts of protecting our trees and woodlands and to further our city's urban forestry programs for the well-being of our present and future generations. Suzanne, I'll present you with this.
Thank you.
And today is just another day that we can all be proud on behalf of the City of Jacksonville, a day to celebrate what's good about our community. I want to thank all of you for coming today.
Good morning. What Arbor Day is. The idea for Arbor Day originally came from Nebraska. It was the lack of trees that led the founding of Arbor Day in the 1800s. Among the pioneers moving into the Nebraska Territory was J. Sterling Morton. He and his wife were lovers of nature, and the home they established was quickly planted with trees, shrubs, and flowers. Morton was a journalist and soon became editor of the Nebraska's first newspaper. He spread agricultural information and his enthusiasm for trees. Trees were needed as windbreaks to keep soil in place, for fuel and building materials, and for the shade from the hot sun. Morton not only advocated tree plant by individuals, but he also encouraged civic organizations and groups to join in. On January 4, 1872, Morton was first proposed a tree plant to be called Arbor Day at the meeting of the Nebraska State Board of Agriculture. The date was set for April 10, 1872. Prizes were offered to counties and individuals for planting the largest number of trees on that day. Today, the most common date for the state observance is the last Friday in April, and several U.S. presidents have proclaimed a National Arbor Day on that date. But a number of state Arbor Days are at other times when planting is better for the weather. Arbor Day has now spread beyond the United States and is observed in many countries in the world. For Jacksonville, this is our 34th Arbor Day event. Please now welcome our students and ensemble for an interpretive dance followed by the Onslow County Forest Ranger, Ricky Atkins.
I don't want to hurt you, but I need to breathe. At the end of it all, you're still my best friend. But there's something inside that I need to release. Which way is right? Which way is wrong? How do I say that I need to move on? close to love you.
Onslow County Forest Ranger, Ricky Atkins.
Good morning. Hope y'all are having a beautiful sunny day. I was scared it was going to rain us out first thing this morning. I'm glad to be here. If the wind would stop blowing just a minute. It's a pleasure to be here in Jacksonville on Arbor Day to present you with the 33rd Tree City USA Award. You had 34 Arbor Day ceremonies, but this is the 33rd one in the program. That is exceptional. I think y'all are the second longest running city in the state. And in the state, there is 72 cities that are Tree City USA approved. So that's quite an accomplishment, and a lot of dedication goes into this to keep it for 33 years. Let me give you a little idea about the program. Tree City USA began in 1976 as a bicentennial project. It was co-sponsored by the National Association of State Foresters and the USDA, or the U.S. Forest Service. The National League of Cities and the U.S. Conference of Mayors are now co-sponsors as well. The Tree City USA program is a partnership between the North Carolina Forest Service and the National Arbor Day Foundation. Awards are presented annually to cities and towns that demonstrate a commitment to making their communities more livable by planting and caring for trees. And trees are very important to our communities. You know, it's already been stated here today what they do for us. And Jacksonville has once again met four criteria for this award. One of them is a public tree ordinance, a tree board, and a community forestry program with an annual expenditure of $2 per capita, and an annual Arbor Day observation and proclamation to celebrate trees, which we're doing here today. For a community forestry program to be effective, it takes the efforts and commitment from an entire community, and that says a lot right there. In Jacksonville, the community forestry program thrives because the combined dedication of the tree board members, the city staff, elected officials, and business community, homeowners, and all the residences who take pride in improving the quality of life in Jacksonville through environmental stewardship. On behalf of the National Arbor Day Foundation and the North Carolina Forest Service, I'd like to proudly present Jacksonville with the 33rd Tree City USA Award. First of all, I would like to call Michael LaCorey up here, if he's out here. There we go. Michael, I know you tried to hide from this, but you're going to be on candid camera here today. You're presented with two stickers to put on your trucks or whatever your organization and parks want you to put it on to proudly display. Appreciate it, Mike.
Thank you.
Okay, I love doing this one. I'd like to call Dr. Woodruff to the podium, please. Dr. Woodruff, you ain't got a bow to many people, but you've been down here, sir. You're going to get a hat today.
Thank you very much.
There you go. Hey, you look pretty good in it, too. All right. We also would like Mayor Sammy Phillips to come up. Mr. Mayor, you have a pin that you hope you can proudly wear on your collar, and I believe y'all have a plaque at the City Hall. this proudly be stuck on there is your 2012 sticker. I think y'all got them lined up on there.
Well, thank you very much.
And if you don't mind standing here now for the final thing, if the committee would come up, the tree committee would come up, we'd like to present the 33rd annual Tree City USA flag. Miss Suzanne, can you help me unfold this? The wind is getting kind of rowdy here. Let's not hide the committee. Yeah. All right. Boy, that thing's waving in the wind just like a flag is supposed to, isn't it? That's quite an accomplishment, and I'm proud to be a part of it. And I thank you for letting me come in and give this award.
The Memorial Tree Program is a legacy of the city of Jacksonville. It began as a simple method of memorializing a loved one with the gift of a tree that would be planted to help with the beautification of Jacksonville. It was successful and many trees were planted. Its success of the past was, however, overshadowed by one event, October 23, 1983, Beirut bomb blast. When news of the loss of life spread quickly around Jacksonville, contributions were made in their memory to the Memorial Tree Program. A single class at Northwoods Park Middle School vowed to plant a tree in honor of each of those who died. With national attention to the blast and of the effort to remember the fallen, funds far in excess of what was needed for the 241 trees were collected. That led to the effort to build the Beirut Memorial, which to this day stands as the largest military memorial ever constructed entirely from contributions. Today, the Memorial Tree Program still remembers, honors, and celebrates events, persons, and activities. Let us pause as we honor those who were named in contributions to the program this past year. Let us give appreciation for those who donated to the program. Pep's Wildfire Girls, in memory of Pep Peterson. Four trees from the Jacksonville Nelson family, in memory of E.L. Lilly, Robert D. Smith, Dr. Karen Johnson Meyerchik, and Walter Vatcher. To participate in the Memorial Tree Program, contact the city manager's office or go online for a contribution form. And now, the Jacksonville Commons Middle School Ladies of Quality.
Hello, I am an eighth grader from Jacksonville Commons Middle School, and I would like to recite a poem about Arbor Day that I have made up with a little bit of help from Claire. To be one of his lovely creations, why do we destroy them across the nations? Ones that give us scenery and air are suddenly disappearing everywhere. But why? Why must we make them die? We need them to be alive. Can we at least try? Please try. We don't need that many parking lots. It's making trees rot. We don't need that many hotel resorts, because trees also have purpose of all sorts. So before you cut down another tree, think of all they do for you and me.
Guys, remember that tree that we used to go to when we were like 3 or 4 years old?
Yeah, I remember that tree.
Oh yeah, I heard that they turned that tree into a park, you know, a park around it. You guys want to go check it out?
Yeah, let's go check it out.
Oh my gosh, they've gotten so pretty and so tall.
Yeah, look at them. Look at their green leaves.
They're so fabulous.
The trees are scheduled for demolition at 3 o'clock tomorrow.
Yep. What? What'd you say? What's she talking about?
Excuse me, ma'am, but what are you talking about?
Those trees are scheduled for demolition tomorrow. They're turning it into a parking lot.
Not these beautiful trees.
Sorry, there's nothing we can do about it.
You can cut it down. It's okay. We will do all that we can do to prevent you guys from getting cut down, okay? We promise, but we'll be back here tomorrow. And as the girls are walking back to their clubhouse to write letters to the state government about why we shouldn't cut down trees, as we begin to write.
Knock, 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 knock. Who is it?
There are letters.
What are these?
Reasons why you should not cut down these beautiful trees.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
We should go to the trees and see how they're doing right now.
Are y'all okay, lovely trees?
Oh, it's a shame that they're gonna cut down the trees. Because trees give off oxygen, which we need to breathe, plus they absorb harmful pollutants from the air, which can damage our lungs.
Trees give us products like paper, building materials, life-saving drugs, and firewood. Also, trees are beautiful to look at, fun to climb, and great to take a nap under.
Trees provide shade for us and our homes on a hot summer day, and they reduce the respiration.
I think we should go now. It's getting kind of late.
Yeah. Bye, trees.
Ding dong!
Who is it?
It's the government people.
Oh my god.
Okay. Oh my god, okay. Answer the door. Okay, cool.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi.
This is from the state government.
Thank you.
Okay. What does it say? Really?
They have to cut down the trees because it's their job.
That's not right.
Can't really do anything about it.
It's not fair.
Okay.
Well, let's go check on these trees.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
Yeah.
About to cut down the trees? No, you can't.
We have to turn those trees into a parking lot.
Don't put your tree. You can't cut down these trees.
They're everything we need.
Save the trees.
They're everything we need.
Save the trees.
They're everything we need.
Yeah.
What are we supposed to do?
What? I don't know. What are we supposed to do?
Where's Lena?
Have you seen her?
Wait. Everybody, stop the chaos. I have something for you.
What's this?
Well, it is a petition signed by all of the locals in Anso County saying that you guys cannot cut down the trees.
What are we supposed to do, guys?
I guess we can't cut down the trees.
Okay, fine, but we'll be back.
Don't litter. Woo! Yay, we don't get to cut down the trees.
And bow.
Ow!
Thank you for that, ladies. That was wonderful. I want to talk for a minute about our work here locally. Recent revisions to the City of Jacksonville Advisory Committees resulted in the merging of the Beautification and Appearance Commission, the Recycling and Solid Waste Collection Committee, and portions of the Trails and Greenways Committee into the new Environmental and Appearance Advisory Committee. This committee serves to advise and assist the city on matters that work to achieve a clean and green Jacksonville. This includes efforts to beautify and enhance the visual quality of the city and its public right-of-ways, trails, and greenways, to reduce litter, to encourage recycling, and reduce non-recyclable solid waste, to promote an environmentally sustainable community, to conserve resources, for habitat preservation, and to educate members of the community and promote or encourage partnerships and community efforts that would advance a clean and green Jacksonville. The committee also encourages the appreciation and care of city trees. The City of Jacksonville Tree Advisory Board is a subcommittee of the Environmental and Appearance Advisory Committee. The committee has created the Clean and Green Star Awards program. The awards are an opportunity to promote and recognize and show appreciation for activities that have advanced the Clean and Green Jacksonville program. Properties are eligible to receive the Business or Residential Appearance Award, while deserving individuals or groups are eligible to receive the Outstanding Community Service Award. It's easy to nominate a property or person you feel is deserving of this prestigious appearance award by contacting City Hall for a nomination form. Thank you.
After Reverend Churchwell closes our observance, you are invited to join us as we plant 5 sycamore trees around Lake Bittner. I want to use an adaptation of an old Greek saying that Warren Buffett is fond of saying, "Someone's sitting in the shade today because someone planted a tree a long time ago." We want you to help plant trees today so that others who come behind us will be able to enjoy their shade. In Jacksonville, we are enjoying the work done by citizens years ago with the Beirut trees, beautification efforts, and an attitude that appearance matters. Join us with the committee or in your own way. Plant a tree, beautify an area, and respect our appearance.
On this Arbor Day, we give thanks for trees. We rest in their shade, breathe in their oxygen, feast on their fruit. Trees anchor the ground beneath our feet and purify the air around us. Their cycles are a silent, faithful witness to your goodness and providence. We give thanks for all life on earth nourished by trees. Let your presence be known among us today and every time we view your trees. Bless them with growth. Bless us with wisdom to nurture growth throughout the world of these life-sustaining companions on earth. This we ask in Christ Jesus' name. Amen.
This concludes the ceremony. If you join us at the planting of the trees beside Lake Bittner.